directed by Severin Fiala and Veronica Franz, starring Riley Keough, Richard Armitage, and Jaden Martell. A soon-to-be stepmom is snowed in with her fiancé's two children at a remote holiday village. Just as relations begin to thaw between the trio, some strange and frightening events take place. I can see The Lodge being a pretty divisive film. Some may find it boring, while others find it to be masterful. I'm on the side of thinking that this is a masterful film and an exercise in tension and old-school horror. There's this ever-present feeling of unease. From beginning to end, you never experience a reprieve from this sense of dread. The story follows a few different characters. We follow brother and sister Aiden and Mia, who have suffered a major loss in their life, who are now being introduced to their father's new fiancé, Grace, who was raised in a cult and is the sole survivor of a mass suicide. Several days before Christmas, the four arrive at the lodge, where the children act openly hostile towards Grace and refuse any efforts to bond with her. When Richard heads back to the city for a work obligation, Grace is left with the two children, and the story takes off from there. It's not very often that horror films make it into my dreams, but this film actually haunted my dreams. This is a deeply disturbing film that is incredibly bleak, and to me is the true definition of horror. I haven't seen the director's previous film, Goodnight Mommy, so I had no preconceived notions going into this movie. The themes in this film are very heavy, from suicide to cults, Christian fundamentalism, and gaslighting. So it's safe to say that the film is very heavy. The two child actors, Jaden Martell and Leah McHugh, are fantastic in this film. They act very natural, and that could be said for the entire cast. It was nice to see Alicia Silverstone in this film, and although her screen time is short, her role is very important. Richard Armitage, as the father who's a bit aloof to the situation, does a great job. But the standout performance for me is Riley Keough as Grace. With everything that she's gone through as a character, you can see that just on her face. And as the story progresses, we get to find out more about her as a character. I'm being purposely vague because I don't want to spoil any of the surprises in this film. The story gets very dark, and just when you think the story can't get any darker, it keeps delving deeper and deeper. The direction and cinematography is beautiful and effortless. The setting is so perfect for that sense of isolation and desperation, and it's perfect for encapsulating that feeling of cabin fever. The Catholic iconography throughout the lodge felt super creepy, and it seemed like the paintings on the walls were watching you. There's not a lot of blood, gore, or kills, but when they do happen, they're impactful. And I do really want to drive home that this film is a slow burn. So don't expect a fast-paced film. This is much more of a psychological horror that tackles heavy themes with a moody atmosphere. Also, bonus points to the directors for putting the thing in the film while the kids are watching television. If you're looking for a film that is unpredictable, dark, moody, and will really challenge you as a filmgoer, I highly recommend checking out The Lodge. With all that said, The Lodge gets an instant classic. This is my favorite horror film of 2020 so far, and comfortably stands shoulder to shoulder with modern classics like The Witch and Hereditary. I'm very much looking forward to adding this film to my collection and re-watching it to do a deeper dive. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to leave a like and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thank you so much for coming by, and I'll see you guys in the next video.